life insurance basically meets a couple of major needs of the investors. Number one is for protection against the adversities of life. In that sense, it works as a risk management tool. It protects our dependents from the adversities of life, like accidents, you've got critical illness, you've got protection from loss of earning, and in certain cases, perhaps from demise. Life insurance provides financial protection in this sense, because in any of these eventualities, it gives money to your dependents. The other important need which life insurance policy meets is a long-term wealth creation. Because there are problems which many of us will face is probably living too long. We have got a retirement age which is in the range of 58 to 60, and the longevity is increasing beyond 75 and 80. So we have to protect ourselves, and we have to save for money for us for our long-term future, for at least 15 to 20 years of retirement period. So if you look at it, our lifestyle and other things are changing. Today if you look at, there are three critical changes which is happening in our society. Number one is our personal balance sheets are getting more and more leveraged. If you look at it today, if I check with any of our employee group, which is say between say 25 and 35, and if I ask them how many of you have taken home loan, personal loan or car loan, and I think 60% of them, they say yes, and they have taken it in last couple of years. It is also reflected in our debt to GDP. Our financial debt to GDP of households is now reaching 5%, which was 4 years back was negligible. It was around maybe 1 or 2%. Now when you have taken these loans and you have got a young family, maybe a spouse earning or not earning, you need that protection. And please remember, the disaster usually never comes with notice. The second need, if you look at it, is our increasing longevity, as I said earlier, together with breakup of our family system. It's not necessarily that our children don't want to look after us, but the economic development and the way in which the jobs are and the opening of our markets, people is now more and more Indian are becoming global Indian, so they may not stay with you. So you have to cover yourself for your longevity, and your long retirement period. So that's another need in terms of a life insurance policy or a long-term saving, which is catered to by the investment in, say, ULIP, for example. Now, ULIP provides you the benefit of capital guarantees many a time. That means all the downside out of a capital market or market-related exposure is being taken care of by the insurer, where you earn the market-related returns on the upside. The other, perhaps the third possible change which is happening, is we are in a long period of a low interest rate, low real interest rate environment. Now when you have got an inflation, like take current case, if you have got a 6% inflation and we have got a 8 or 8.5% saving rate, now 2.5% real return is not going to provide you a very good retirement life. So how do you protect yourself against that? Now that protection comes by having a market related return, some sort of exposure to equity by investing in a long term insurance plan. Now coming to how much insurance one should have, I think there is no thumb rule, but broadly if you look at it, you need to have say 20 times of your earning, that much of life insurance you should have. Another way you look at it, if you want to have a retirement money which is say equal to a 50% of your last income, then it should be you should have a saving of at least 20 to 25 years. The other critical part you should also take into account is your life insurance need and your total financial corpus needs also depends upon your number of dependents, your risk appetite, so that what kind of debt equity mix you would like to have, what kind of lifestyle you have, what age group you are in. So some of these factors also decide how much insurance and how much long-term saving need you have. Because please remember a couple of basic principles. Number one is, all the need of your long-term saving as well as protection, you need not buy at one time. You can buy policies at a different point of time, and you must have seen about yourself. The life, the need changes as per the composition of our family changing, our creeping lifestyle changes, as I call it. that also makes impact on your need for the insurance. And another principle you should remember is, you take the insurance policy later in life, the cost of insurance goes up. If you take it, for example, at the age of 35 and you take it at the age of 45, whereas you may pay for your risk cover on a level premium basis, at least double the premium for the same amount of protection. So earlier you begin, you are always better off. Another most important principle which I'll sign off with is that life insurance is not a static decision. It's a as dynamic and responsive decision as what life is.